Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be sharing with you what's new from Wet n Wild. I have talked about a few things from Wet n Wild already in past videos, which I'll link below and stuff, but I wanted to give you my overview on the new collection that came out recently and just my opinion on each product. I do have some clips of me applying most of the products. I actually started this video out as a first impressions, and I just did not like how it was turning out. I just did not like how my footage was turning out. Like, I don't think that I'm a good first impressions YouTuber. Like, some people are so good at making their videos and they're just like comprehensive and they give such good reviews. I was just kind of like babbling in my video as I was putting it on, and I just didn't feel like it was the best that I could do. Plus, when I'm trying a new product, I prefer to kind of sleep on it before I decide what I think about it. You know, I like to have at least like a day or two, preferably like 3 or 4 times of trying the product before I decide exactly how I feel about it. That way I can try it with other different products and that kind of thing, and really give you guys a good review of my opinion of what I think of it, you know, like well-rounded. With the first impressions, I feel like it's just kind of like, well, if it didn't work out, there could be a million reasons why, and it could be something really easy to change that could make it work. You know what I mean? So that's just my opinion. Like I said, I love watching other people's first impressions. I just don't feel like I'm very good at them. So anyways, so that's why some of the clips that you see, I might be talking and stuff in them, because I was trying to film a first impressions, but I decided to just scrap that and refilm my review after I've now used these products for several days. So the first product I'm going to talk about is the Photo Focus Foundation. I have 2 shades of these. I have the shade Golden Beige and Desert Beige. Desert Beige is a little bit darker than Golden Beige. And what I ended up doing is I've been mixing these 2 shades together. I think that Desert Beige would probably be okay on its own, but I don't want to waste this one because I know I'm only going to get darker from here on out, more tan in the summer. So I'm just kind of mixing them together and then bronzing up my face a little bit extra if I have to. So this foundation is supposed to be tested under 7 different light conditions. So it's supposed to have no flashback, and it's supposed to be really good for any light conditions, natural light, fluorescent lighting, flash photography. It's supposed to be good for all of those things, which is a big claim, you know, it is, but it's cool that they do that. This does not have any SPF in it, which makes sense because that can cause flashback. This is what the applicator looks like, and it's a very interesting applicator, but I actually have been enjoying it. My first impression of it was like, this is really weird, I don't know how I feel about this. It's kind of angled up, if you can see that, just slightly, ever so slightly angled up, so you kind of like scoop it up. And then I've just been applying it all over my face with the applicator. You want to make sure not to apply it to any like open breakouts, because you don't want to get bacteria in here. That's the one downside of having the applicator that goes back in the bottle rather than like a pump or something, but I don't mind it. So far I'm enjoying the applicator, and yeah, so you just use that, I apply it all over my face, and then I go in with a beauty blender. I have found that the beauty blender is the absolute best way to apply this foundation. After I've applied it to my face, I blend it out with a beauty blender. That helps spread the product evenly. It's very liquidy, so I feel like when I tried it with a brush, it got kind of streaky, so I like the beauty blender for that. It also gives it a very natural finish. This is buildable, and I do recommend, if you want fuller coverage, to do a couple layers, especially if you're using a beauty blender, because unfortunately the beauty blender does soak up a bit of the product, being a very liquidy product. However, I really love the finish of it. This is a very buildable foundation too, so you can do multiple layers, and you can really choose what degree of coverage you want. So if you just want a light, really almost no makeup look, you can get that. If you want fuller coverage, you can get that. I don't think you can get quite full coverage with this foundation. It's just not that kind of foundation. It's more of a natural looking foundation. But I really, really like this stuff. I have really been enjoying it, and I definitely recommend it. On the scale of matte to dewy, I would put this right in the middle, because I feel like it looks pretty matte after I've set it. So like, I kind of chose how matte I wanted it to look, but I feel like it looks really natural. Like when you put it on the skin, it doesn't dry to a complete matte finish, but if you set it with the powder, you can get that matte finish. When you put it on the skin, you know, it stays a little bit like damp, tacky for a while, which I like, because I've been really into using cream contour products and cream blush products and everything like that. So it's nice to have a foundation that doesn't dry right away, so those products blend into it. So I really like that. But then I set it with the powder and it sets beautifully, and it has the perfect, like, it's matte enough, but it's not like flat matte, you know? It still has a bit of glow to it, and I just really like it. I really am enjoying this foundation, so this is a definite A plus for me. Next, I have their Photo Focus Concealer. I have the shade Light Medium Beige. Wet n Wild has quite a few concealers, I think, don't they, that I've tried. So far, I would say this one is my favorite. I applied this only on my under eyes, and that's usually where I use like a liquidy, you know, concealer like this. I go for under the eyes. I applied this under my eyes, and then I blended it out with my beauty blender like I always do with my concealer. One thing I noticed about this is that it dries very quickly, so I actually end up doing one eye at a time when I use this. I would recommend doing that, just one area of your face at a time, because this dries very quickly. I'm not sure why. I've never had a concealer that dries quickly like this one does, but it's like I would notice that when I would put it under both eyes like I'm used to doing, by the time I would get to the second eye, it would not blend out. It was like it had already set, and it would be kind of like really hard to blend out with my beauty blender. So one eye at a time. But I do like it. I think this has really good coverage. This is the best coverage of a concealer by Wet n Wild that I've ever tried. I have their like twist up ones, and those are nice, but they don't have as good of coverage as this. And for the under eyes, I think most people want a bit of coverage. I feel like it looks very natural. It's not super intense. Like I have to throw in, you know, Tarte Shape Tape. It's not the Tarte Shape Tape. It's not full coverage, and it does smooth things out, color correct. And I feel like it brightens the under eyes a little bit, which is really nice. I like how it looks. I just think it looks really nice. I also realized today that I didn't actually end up setting my under eye concealer with a yellow setting powder like I usually do. All I did was I blended it out, and then I went on and did my cream contour, and then I set my whole face with the powder, and I put some powder under my eyes. But I didn't actually specifically set the under eyes because I didn't feel the need to. Usually when I put concealer under there, it feels kind of tacky and I feel like I need to set it, but I didn't feel that with this, so that's very interesting. So this isn't the best concealer I've ever tried, but it is a lot cheaper than my favorite concealer, and I do really like the performance. So I would give this concealer a solid A. Next, I wanted to quickly talk about these cream stick products. I'm not going to spend too much time on them because I did do a complete review and comparison on all of the cream contour products from the drugstore. I'll link that below if you want to see that. But I wanted to talk about these quickly just to kind of give you my final thoughts after having used them for a few more days. I still really love the contour stick. That is my absolute favorite. I have the shade Where's Walnut. Highly recommend this if you want to get into cream contouring or if you like cream contouring. I love this one. This is the best. The highlighter I do not like. I tried it today with a stippling brush, and I tried to apply it to my cheekbones, and I do not like it. If they come out with a different shade, I would definitely try it, because I do feel like this white pink shade is not good for my skin tone. It's just not flattering, so I would try another shade if they came out, but I still don't even like the quality of it. Like, I just don't feel like it's very good, you know? I feel like it's kind of greasy, and I don't like the highlighter. And I kind of feel the same about the blush. I don't really love the blush stick. The shade I have is Floral Majority. I don't know, it's a really, really pretty color. It looks like it would be really pretty, but I just don't like it. So I guess I would pass on these. I would say the highlighter and the blush are a fail for me. The concealer sticks, I'm gonna give these a grade of a C because they're nice. And if you use stick concealers, they're probably great for you. I just don't use stick concealers very much. I tried using it under my eyes, which is the only main place that I use concealer and color correcting, and it didn't really work at all because it was just too thick. It didn't blend out. Now, I do use this on occasion on like the bridge of my nose, up here a little bit to highlight, but I don't feel like it worked super well on my forehead. The only place that I do enjoy using these is on my jawline. I feel like that's the one spot where it works. It blends into the skin really well, and I really like how that looks. So these concealer sticks are a C. The shades I have are Nude for Thought and You're a Natural. Now let me know if you guys have tried these and what you think about them. I think they're just, you know, just a C. Okay, next I want to talk about these Wet n Wild cushion products. I'm going to give these grades. Okay, let's start with the contour one. So I have the MegaCushion Contour. This one I use to contour my nose, and I use in that video as well. And I like it because it's a very thin formula, so it's pretty forgiving and you can be really flexible with it. But I did notice that it kind of wiped away my foundation as I've been using it on my nose. I feel like it doesn't blend in super well. So I'm gonna give this a B. If you love cushion products and you're used to them and you're, you know, comfortable using them, then you probably will enjoy this. I'm not seeing myself using this a lot. The highlighter, again, I have to say this is a fail because it's that same pink pearly shade that does not flatter my skin tone, and I'm just not going to be using it. Again, if they come out with another shade, I'll try it, but I just don't like this shade. It's got a little bit better pigmentation than the stick one, but it's just not the shade for me, so I don't personally like it. And then I have these two color correctors. These are okay. I tried the green one, I've tried on trouble spots, and I've tried the yellow one under my eyes to brighten. I don't feel like the yellow one really worked under my eyes. I feel like the green one kind of worked on red spots, but I'm not exactly sure how I'm supposed to use these. I'm still experimenting with these, so right now I don't even want to give them a grade. If I had to give them a grade, I'd probably say like a C or a D, just because I don't see myself using them. I'm not an expert on color correcting, so I gotta learn more. Next, I have the Photo Focus Pressed Powder, and this is a, I'll tell you right now, this is a definite hit. Now, let's see, the shade that, do I have a specific shade? Yes, I have the shade Tan Beige. I'm not sure how many shades they came out with, but I know there's multiple shades, which is really nice. This powder is so nice. It's really smooth. I mean, you can just tell by looking at it, like it almost looks like it's baked. It has like a marble effect to it that like baked products have, and it's just so soft and finely milled. It's insane. It has a touch of pigment, or at least it seems like it has a touch of pigment, but I don't feel like it does. Like, I did my cream contouring and blush, and then I set my entire face with this powder after that, and you can still see the blush and the contour under it. So I don't feel like this has a ton of pigment. I feel like it's perfect for a light setting powder. But I would definitely recommend still obviously trying to color match yourself, because if you use one that's way too light, it probably wouldn't work. My only complaint is kind of a weird one, and it's probably like so trivial, but I don't like how the package is rounded like this, because I feel like it takes up more space in my drawer, and if I travel with it, I'd rather it be flat, you know, because some of Wet n Wild's compacts are flat and I like that better. But I don't know if it's like a baked product, maybe it has to be like that, or who knows, I don't know, that's just a little thing. But I really love this product. I give this guy an A+. Okay, next let's talk about this highlighter. This is the ColorIcon Rainbow Highlighter in Unicorn Glow. This product is not as new as these other ones. This one has been out for a while, but I just got my hands on it. I just had to. It's so pretty, you know? I just had to. However, I tried it on my face only once, and it was a disaster. I'll show you the clip. You can see my reaction. I was so shocked with how this looked on my skin, and I only tried the yellow and orange colors because I wanted a somewhat natural highlight. This is not going to give you any kind of a natural highlight, so just forget about that right now. This, however, is very beautiful. If you are into, like, creative looks, I mean, look at that. Like, that's really pretty. I can have a lot of fun with this, just swatching it, like, oh, that's so cool. You gotta swatch. Oh, so pretty. So it's beautiful. Very metallic. This would make a really pretty eyeshadow palette. Like, if you want to do rainbow eyes, I think these would be perfect. Or if you want to do like a really graphic look, like if you want to look like you literally have a rainbow on your face for like a creative makeup look, this would be good for that. I feel like most people would look at this and not think that they're going to use it every day. They're going to think either, you know, I'm going to use this on special occasions when I want a really crazy creative look, or they think I just want to collect this because it's Wet n Wild and I love Wet n Wild and it's a fun, awesome product. As long as you keep that in mind, I would give this an A. Not quite an A+. It's a little bit chunky, just a little bit chunky, I feel like, and powdery, but I enjoy it, so I would give it an A. Next, I have two eyeshadows to talk about. These are both their Au Naturel eyeshadow palettes. This is the older one and Bare Necessities, and this is Nude Awakening. This is a newer one, but I wanted to talk about both of them because they're both fairly new to me. In the clip that I'm going to show you, I'm wearing the Nude Awakening palette on my eyes, and I really love this one. This one is my favorite. I love all of the shades. I love that they have this light matte cream shade. That's really important. The other one doesn't have that. I love that they have this nice neutral taupey blending shade, and then lots of dark shades. I feel like they don't really need all of these dark shades. I feel like they could take one and make it maybe like a shimmery version of this, or a matte version of one of these would be really nice. Like one more matte blending transition shade would be really nice. But overall, I really love this palette. I love the look that I created with it. I feel like there's a lot of versatility, like a lot of looks that you can get with this palette. I'm kind of excited to keep playing around with it. The shadows are really nice. I really like the quality of these shadows. They're a tad powdery. There is quite a bit of fallout when I use them, which is unfortunate, but I still feel like once they're on the eyes, once you have them where you want them, you know, it looks really nice. So I really do like it. I would give this palette an A minus. And the Bare Necessities one, today I am wearing all this one, and I don't love this one as much. I don't feel like the colors are as interesting, I guess. There's a pretty good variety, but I don't feel like I can get quite as much versatility out of it. It does have that matte neutral taupe shade, but it doesn't have a matte highlight shade, like a matte brow bone base shade. So I kind of don't like it because of that. Like I said, I am wearing it today all over my eyes and I pretty much like it. I used the matte highlight from the other palette though to complete the look. There's no matte black. I don't know. It's just, there's just kind of some weird shades in here, but I don't feel like it's bad. And if you're looking at this and you're thinking like, this is the one that I want, you know, these are the colors that I gravitate towards and totally go for it, I just don't feel like I gravitate towards these shades as much. This is the main shade right here that I'm using, that I have mostly all over my lid, which I like. I like the look that I have today. Don't get me wrong. It's just not as, I don't like it as much as the other one. So if I gave the other one an A minus, I'd give this one a B plus. Next, I want to talk about this Ultimate Brow Highlighting Stick. This is not new. This has been out for a while, but I finally got my hands on it and I just, it seems like the kind of thing that I would really like, so I wanted to try it. I'm trying to see if there's a shade. I don't think so. I think this is just one shade, but it's this really pretty light pink. There, you can see that right there. Pretty light pink, just like a cream pencil. I love this. This is an A plus. So I have only used this in one spot though. I've only used this on my waterline, but I feel like if it can stand up to the waterline, it can stand up to anything. This would be really good on the inner corner for brightening your eyes if you're especially tired. Really good on the brow bone. I think that's what it's sort of really designed for, is to highlight the brow bone. And it's nice that it's a cream product because it can blend out and look very, very natural. So it doesn't look like you have powder. It doesn't have any shimmer in it. Really nice product. A plus. So glad I got this. Next, let's talk about the mascaras. So the first mascara I'm going to talk about is the Lash Renegade Mascara. I have the shade Brazen Black. When I first tried this, my first impressions, I was not impressed. I was confused and disappointed, and that's one of the main reasons why I wanted to refilm it, because I just didn't know what I thought, and it's just one of those things, like, you gotta try it multiple times to really understand how you feel about it. I like the packaging. I mean, the packaging looks like, you know, kind of dangerous and kind of cool, but here's what the wand looks like. I find myself that I really enjoy from like here down, like that's the part of the wand that I really like, is like this base part. This ball tip, I have no idea what to do with that. I feel like every time I've tried to use it, it makes my lashes look clumpy in a bad way. And I don't mind a little bit of clumpy, like the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara clumpy, like I like that kind of a look. But this, it's not thickening, it's just clumping with this ball tip. So I really like this part though. This is really good for getting in really close to the lash line and kind of getting the base of your lashes to where you look like you almost have eyeliner on. It's really good for that. So I really like that about it. I just don't feel like this, the ball tip is helping out the mascara at all. I feel like it's just kind of a gimmicky thing that they added. As for my lashes, let me get a little bit closer. I like how they look today, okay. I just don't feel like they're what I would choose to have my lashes look like every day. So I feel like they look really, really natural, which probably for most people is a good thing. I usually go for thicker, clumpier look, not super clumpy, but just, you can see in my videos, you guys know what my lashes usually look like. But this is really nice for like a natural everyday, almost even like a no makeup look. It's nice. This doesn't strike me as like they were aiming to be a natural mascara though, just because it's what it's called and like how it's packaged and stuff. But I mean, I think it's a nice natural mascara. So if I was gonna give this a grade, I'll give it a B minus. It's really hard for me to grade drugstore mascaras because I just don't feel like, I haven't found any drugstore mascara that I love, like my high-end ones. To be fair, this is decent. It does a good job. It's just a little out there, so I give it a B minus. The next mascara I have is this MegaSlim Skinny Mascara, and this one is a skinny mascara, obviously. It's designed to, I think it's designed to be on lower lashes or, you know, wherever, however you want to use it. But I got this with the intention of using it on my lower lashes because right now I use the e.l.f. one, which I really enjoy. And I've been using this one lately Now, I don't know if you can see, I'm gonna hold it up as close as I can. There are fibers in here. When you take it out, it looks like the wand is covered in fur. Like, and it doesn't say anywhere on here that it's a fiber mascara, at least that I've seen. So that really surprised me. When I first took this out, I was like, why is this covered in fur? Like, why are there fiber looking things on here? What am I gonna do with that? It kind of made me nervous because I've had really bad experiences with fiber mascaras, but it's okay. I don't feel like it's that thickening. I do have it on my lower lashes today. The bristles have more of a natural feel to them, and that could be what I'm seeing instead of the, like, it's not actually fibers, it could just be the bristle. I really don't know, but I don't feel like this separates the lashes as much. I feel like my e.l.f. one separates the lashes and coats each individual lash a little bit better. I feel like this one gives kind of more of a wash of color on my lower lashes, but it doesn't like thicken each individual lash that much like my e.l.f. one does. So that's what I've noticed. I don't hate this though. I like it. I'm gonna keep using it, and I can't tell you which one I like more. I feel like they're pretty different from each other, so I'm gonna use each one for different things, if that makes sense. So I don't know which one I like more, but I do like the skinny mascara. If I had to give this a grade, I would give it a B+. Okay, then the last product I want to talk about is what I have on my lips today. This is the MegaCushion Soft Matte Lip Cream. I do not like this. I don't know what you guys think, having watched this video, watched me talking. I don't like this lip color. Not the color that I don't like. The color is fine. It's not for everybody. But I don't like the way that it's sitting on my lips. And this is, there's a swatch of it. So it looks really bright, really intense, but it doesn't stay on the lips like that. I feel like it's getting piecey. Can you see? I don't know. I did a bunch of coats and I didn't feel like it ever ended up looking how I wanted it to look. This is the applicator, so it's kind of a weird applicator. I did go in, applied it with the applicator, and then I went in again with a lip brush, and I had to like blot it and rub it together. It just didn't sit well on the lips. Like, you know, like one application and you're done. Like, it wasn't like that at all. It was a lot of work to get it to sit decently, and I still don't love how it looks. I just don't love how it's sitting on my lips. This is in the shade Melonette, like it is. I think they have 3 or 4 other shades. I don't see myself really using this, unfortunately. The packaging is so cute. I love it. But yeah, I just don't, it's too much work. I don't like it. One thing that I wanted to mention that I like way better from Wet n Wild is their Liquid Catsuit Matte Liquid Lipsticks. This one is in the shade Flame of the Game, so this is really, I think, pretty similar. It's a little bit more red, but it's pretty similar to this color. So if you really like this color, you might want to get Flame of the Game, because these are amazing. I did a complete lip swatch video. I compared these to the Jordana Sweet Cream matte lipsticks. I will link that below if you haven't seen that, but I adore these. So I did recently review these too. The MegaCushion lip soft matte lip creams though, no, it's a fail. All right guys, that's it for this video. I had a lot of fun with this. I think it was cool because there were some products that I absolutely adore that are aces, and some products that are fails, and a lot in between. So I think that was a pretty good, you know, ace or fail video. Let me know what you guys think. What have you tried? What do you love? What do you think you want to try now that you've seen my video? Let me know if you have any questions on any of these products. Let me know that too. I'm always happy to answer your questions. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. That helps other people find me in the YouTube world. Make sure you're subscribed. I have been posting videos 5 days a week, you guys. I've been doing it. But I try to post at least 3 to 5 times a week. So I hope that you will subscribe so that you don't miss any of my videos. And thank you so much for watching, you guys. I really appreciate you all, and I'll talk to you again very soon. Bye.